Next, we will study about the reactions of haloalkanes, means alkyl halides. Okay, so basically, students, the reactions of haloalkanes are divided into these three categories. First one is the nucleophilic substitution. Second is elimination reaction. Third one is your reaction with metals. We are going to study in this class about each and every of these reaction categories. Okay, first one is your nucleophilic substitution reaction. So students, nucleophilic substitution reaction, first of all you need to know is that what is a nucleophile. About nucleophiles, you had studied in the earlier class also, in class 11th also it was in your course, what are the nucleophiles. So nucleophiles, as the name is, the nucleophiles are basically the groups which have extra electrons for donating, or you can say which have extra negative charge, so that is why they are attracted towards the nucleus. That is why they are known as nucleophiles. Okay, and also they are known as nucleus loving. Okay, so basically, as the name is, nucleophilic substitution reaction. First of all, what is a substitution reaction? A substitution reaction is the reaction in which one group replaces another group. Okay, so this is nucleophilic substitution, means the halogen is replaced by the nucleophile. Okay, so in this type of reaction, a nucleophile reacts with haloalkane, which acts as the substrate having partial positive charge on the carbon atom bonded to the halogen. A substitution reaction takes place and halogen atom, which is called the leaving group, departs as the halide ion. Okay, so this is the example of a nucleophilic substitution reaction, in which this is the symbol of a nucleophile which is reacting with a haloalkane having a carbon and a halogen polar bond. Okay, and this part of the halogen, this one, okay, this will be replaced by the nucleophile. Okay, so nucleophile will take place of halogen atom, and this halogen atom will be released in this case. Okay, so this is why we are calling it as nucleophilic substitution reaction, as you are seeing in this, that the nucleophile is replacing the halogen atom in it. Okay, students, one more thing, a substitution reaction takes place when a leaving group departs from a substrate. Okay, so here the leaving group is your halogen atom. Okay, next we will study about the mechanism of nucleophilic substitution reaction. Okay, so students, basically the mechanism of the nucleophilic substitution reaction has two types. One is the SN1 and the other one is the SN2. SN1 and SN2. This one is known as the unimolecular substitution reaction, nucleophilic substitution reaction, and this is known as bimolecular nucleophilic substitution reactions. Okay, so first of all, now we will study about the mechanism of the nucleophilic substitution reaction through the SN1 and SN2 mechanism one by one. First, we will study about the SN2 mechanism. Here's your SN2 mechanism. Okay. So students, basically the reaction between the methyl chloride here, I am showing you, this is the reaction between methyl chloride and hydroxide ion. This is your hydroxide ion and this is your methyl chloride. Okay, so the reaction between the methyl chloride and the hydroxide ion, this yields methanol and chloride ion. Okay, so this reaction basically follows the second order kinetics, that is the rate of the reaction depends upon the concentration of both the reactants. Okay, so basically students, here you can see that here you have two reactants. One is your nucleophile, which is your hydroxide ion, and one is your alkyl halide, which acts as a substrate. Okay, so this nucleophile is reacting with this substrate. So though there are two reactants. Okay, so as it is said that this is a second order kinetics, means the rate of the reaction will depend on the concentration of both of these reactants. Okay, so as the rate of the reaction is depending on both of these on the concentration of both of these reactants. That is why this SN2 mechanism is known as a bimolecular nucleophilic substitution mechanism. Okay, so basically in this reaction, the incoming nucleophile interacts with the alkyl halide, causing the carbon atom, carbon halide bond to break while forming a new hydroxide and hydroxide carbon bond. Okay, so these two process takes place simultaneously in the single step. Okay, as you can see that there is no further any other step. This is the whole reaction is happening in the single step. Okay, so there is no intermediate in this reaction. There is a single, this is a single step process, and as the reaction progresses, the bond between the carbon atom and the halogen starts weakening, and the bond between the carbon and the hydroxide ion strengthens. Okay, so this is how the reaction takes place, and at this place you can see that the configuration of the carbon atom under the attack inverts in much the same way as the umbrella is turned inside out when caught in a strong wind. Okay, so that is why we are saying that here it is having inversion of configuration. How we are saying this, that you can see here that here we are having halogen. Okay, and this nucleophile is attacking from this side. Okay, so that is why this whole structure of this alkyl halide, you are saying that it is just being opposite of what it was earlier. Okay, so here you can see that the hydroxide ion is attacking from the opposite side of the halogen atom, because of which this whole configuration gets inverted. Okay, this whole configuration gets inverted here. Okay, so that is why we are saying this, that here happens the inversion of the configuration. Okay, SN2 mechanism is that mechanism which follows the second order kinetics, in which the whole reaction rate depends on the concentration of both the reactants, and the nucleophile attacks the carbon atom with the halogen atom from the opposite side of the halogen atom, which inverts the configuration of the alkyl halide, due to which it is known as the inversion of configuration. Okay, and this is a bimolecular substitution reaction. That is why it is named as SN2 reaction, or you can say it's SN2 mechanism. This is a single step process without any intermediate. Okay, so this is all about your SN2 mechanism. One more thing, that as you all have studied earlier, that there are three kinds of alkyl halides, which are primary, secondary and tertiary. Okay, so the question arises that which of the among them will follow the SN2 mechanism. Okay, since this reaction requires the approach of the nucleophile to from the opposite side of the leaving group. Okay, this is your leaving group, this is the opposite side. Okay, so as you all know that if this reaction mechanism follows the attack of the nucleophile from the opposite side of the nucleophile. Okay, so due to which if there will be a bulky group on this side, okay, if on the opposite side of the halogen atom we will have a bulky group, then the attack of the nucleophile towards this side will become difficult. Okay, so it will be easier when there is a small group to opposite to the halogen atom. Okay, so that is why in this case the order of reactivity among the primary, secondary, tertiary is follows this way. Primary alkyl halides are more prone to the SN2 mechanism than the secondary and then the tertiary. Okay, so tertiary alkyl halides are least reactive in this mechanism, because they have bulky group on the opposite side of the halogen atom, due to which the nucleophile is not able to attack the carbon atom properly because it doesn't find a place for attacking it, as you can see here that it is attacking from the opposite side. Okay, so that is why it follows this reactivity series, that is primary will be more reactive than the secondary and which will be more reactive than the tertiary.